supposed to have any allowance?
Yeah, but it's better.
Well, I guess it's just your tough luck, huh?
But I always spend it.
Oh! No, you don't. I told you. I said you could leave.
But I gotta have that money.
Later.
But I gotta have it now.
Why?
I gotta give you the 15 minutes.
No.
But they might sell them all.
Who'll sell them all?
The store.
And they'll just get some more in.
But I want it now.
Nope.
Well, you've got money. You can go to sleep, can't you?
No, I can't.
Why not?
Maybe your mom don't want you to have it.
Of course she does. She always gives me everything. Come on, it's just $5.
Sorry, son, I can't do it.
Oh, you're not rich. She just fooled around and married you. Boy, did she get cooked.
Seems like she's used to that. Now, I told you, she's asleep.
I always wake her up.
Not anymore, you don't.
Not even if the house burns down.
Nah, don't you be getting any ideas.
Yeah. I gotta have that money. Well, don't you just have that much? Just $5 million.
Yeah, I got it.
You give it to me.
Why should I? Nobody gave it to me.
What do you mean?
I mean, I earned it. If you want it, you'll get it the same way.
Doing what?
Well, you could start with the front lawn out there.
The lawn? That'll take a whole hour.
I'd like to make $5 an hour when I was your age.
Are you going to be like this, old man? When I was 4 hours, 3 mornings to late at night. And every 10 minutes after, somebody tells the story of his life. Fine, we've got a garden.
Well? How about cleaning the garage?
Garage?
Yeah, I took a couple of suitcases out there last night. I couldn't find a place to turn down.
Look, if you're trying to prove you're the world's best dad, I've got news for you. You're not. What for? I'll get that money and I will get it cleaning up some dirty old garage. I'm
hungry. All right. Come on, now. Let's go in and we'll get some. Later. Come on, I'll make you some eggs.
No, I hate it. I want a check to cover donuts.
Flapjacks? I'll make you some flapjacks to make those donuts taste like Starbucks.
I don't like this. I've never tasted. I'd rather have it donuts.
Come on, let's go stir them.
I don't want to stir them. I want you to go to the supermarket to cover donuts.
I gotta get your mom's breakfast first.
What?
She's the one I married, and I have you real nice work.
Aren't you
very
nice to me?
Sure I am.
They go to the store and get me chocolate covered donuts.
Yeah, come on, let's go get some breakfast.
You're not a nice man after this, but no me.
And how about helping an old me go get some breakfast?
Sorry.
Now, hold on, girl.
I'll start out burning.
All right, you went for it. Oh, hello. I'll be through in just a minute. There. Oh, yes, I will. And I'm going to show you all the eggs and pancakes. You'll first.
Gee, it's off to a great start. I guess you just asked that fat child was born.
Well, you did that, remember?
Oh, yes, and Connie never let me forget it.
Thank heaven she's not down yet.
Yeah, it would have been the shortest marriage on record.
If I even look at her little darling, certainly, she pounced for a week. Oh, if only Ted, my sister's a wonderful girl, but a lousy mother.
Well, you know what Ed did? They killed her, did it?
You know, she's been very overprotective since then. Oh, my worry is, who's going to protect us from her kids? What a shame it won't last. But I did so enjoy seeing that little brat face.
There's a lot of men in that corn husker.
Corn distributor.
But you know, he still has them too. The feeling he learned about disciplinary.
Grandma!
Well, you know, I wasn't for this marriage at first. Until I saw him there. You know, Tommy went with such spineless creatures. I'm going to have a talk with her. I do want this marriage to last. You know, she wouldn't admit it, but she's been terribly lonely the past 6 years.
As far as that goes, she was lonely while Ned was alive. I mean, that job of his, he was never home.
I never did get to know him very well. I don't think Connie did either.
Oh, but Chris is different.
I just didn't know how lucky he was.
Oh, yes, I do. Why, I'm the luckiest girl in the whole world. You see this big fireman get up at the crack of dawn.
Oh, he's up in the kitchen fixing Debbie some breakfast.
Oh, that sweet guy. I just know she's going to adore him.
I'm sure of that.
And the guy on the ground, oh, the other one's safe, completely insane!
when he's 21, too.
Yeah. Well, you guys put on some real clothes. I bet we could buy. In fact, I know we could.
Oh, but if we got caught, my parents would die. They'd kill my dad. And what about yours?
You mean that person I'm not speaking to?
Did he say something to this morning?
Oh, yes. He was a slight courteous man. And so was I. But he knows now I won't be pushed around. Never been camping, have they? No, but then neither have I. Oh, once I went to the lodge up there on the Well, then, Buddy and Ned are up there. Aren't you, Catalina? Oh, they have wonderful camps and they're really well supervised.
No, but nothing.
Well, that way they can gradually get used to it.
Kids don't have to gradually get used to camping. They take to it like ducks to water.
You know, I think you married me just to get a family.
That's right.
Most normal men would use heaven and earth to get away from children. Are you sure you don't want to take mother and see the kids?
That's not a bad idea. You know, that Sheila wouldn't look half bad in a pair of jeans.
Oh, honestly. And I thought I married a long book. And you want to take a whole Sunday school class on our honeymoon.
More than marriers. Now look, first weekend we'll get Jeff's book. And we'll go down the lake. Then we'll drop the kids off with my sister Vivian. And the two of us will head out.
You mean Lisa was a perfect stranger?
Don't worry. Simple Whitman, I mean. She's a very good kid. She's got six of her own.
Chris, I just couldn't do that to Debbie. Leave her with a perfect stranger? She would feel so unloved and unwanted. That could affect her whole life.
Was Buddy and Nettie there?
I absolutely refuse to quarrel with you. Besides, there's always a way to make everybody happy. Well, isn't there?
Don't hear any complaints out of me.
Do that often?
Never found it necessary before.
Anything can
Well, I don't know, but they didn't bother camp.
I'll just bet they didn't.
Well, sounds like there's kind of a little ripple in the matrimonial scene.
Ripple? More like a whole tidal wave.
Oh, over the children, no doubt.
Oh, well, I know whose side you're on, Mother, so there isn't any need to even discuss it.
Oh, but you should have seen Debbie go with him, holding his hand all the way out, going in the car.
She's too young to even know any better, honestly. He acts like he owns us body and soul.
Well, doesn't he?
Well, of course he doesn't. Why, last night, he embarrassed Nedra so badly in front of her friends. I wouldn't be at all surprised if she'd have left home.
Oh, that means she'll probably stay with me.
This is her home. I don't want her at your house.
Ah, she wouldn't like living with me anyway. I wouldn't want her to say keep the same hours as you do.
Well, I always say you have to treat children as if they were little adults.
So they can treat us like children.
Are you just getting up?
Like mother, like daughter.
I wanted to make sure that person you married was out of the house.
Oh.
Now, Nettie, I'm sorry about last night. Chris is really new at this business of being a father.
He is not my father.
Well, he'd like to be. No, he doesn't. Oh, don't you see it, Mother? All he wants to do is make a perfect fool out of you. He's trying to take everything he's ever let us do so that you'll feel like a completely incompetent, weak, inefficient goober.
He's what?
You just what? He's going to change our eating habits. Our sleeping habits, our spending habits, and he's determined to change us if he has you to fall with.
Oh, no, not that we need changing, no.
Just a Mr. Christopher Barker has to prove that he's a big shot in the wide open spaces.
Oh, that was a good speech.
Well, he's not changing me. I'm not giving in to him one inch. Now, Ned, sit down. You know you're very dear to me. I'm not in a lot of moods to listen to a lot of sentimental flesh, Mother.
Why did you do it? We were getting along fine. You were getting along fine. Your mother gave you everything that your little heart desired. Of course, she had to work 6 days a week to do it.
Mother, please. You said things would be even better after you married him. Why, you know, he wouldn't even give Junior $5 to go buy a toy machine, huh? Oh, and Debbie, your precious Debbie. He wouldn't even give her $1 to go get an ice cream sundae.
Good. She lives off sweet.
You're not going to do this to me anymore, Mom. Well, I'm sorry, Amanda, that this has all happened. Just sit down and calm down. Friends will probably be over here any minute. Who's he working on now? Bud or Debbie?
Oh, he's gone by boat.
Oh, so he's trying to bribe us now, is he? Well, I'm not interested.
Oh, well, you'd make a lousy water hearing, but it's too much for him.
Is that so, Grandma? Well, it just so happens I can water ski. I got it the very first time I tried. Besides, Moose's father's getting a boat, and I can ride into any old time I want to.
Somebody better tell him.
Tell who?
Moose's father. Well, I know a moose. He'll probably put pipes underneath it, jack it up, cut it in two, and then drive it through my father.
Grandma, will you stop making wisecracks about my friends? We had an incident ever since he drove across your flower bed. That was 3 months ago.
Well, it took me 3 years to get the roses up there.
They only did it in fun.
Oh, well, next time they can have fun and drive it through your flower bed when your father goes.
He is not my father! Nedra, you don't need to tell the whole neighborhood. Well, I don't care. He's not. He can't come waltzing in here pretending that he is. Grandma, next time my friends come over, will you do me one little favor, please? Would you please try and find something endearing about them? There must be something.
Oh. I know. You say that all the kids are crazy about going to the high school, and I'd be crazy too if I had to be around them as much as that.
Do you see what I mean?
Mother, Nettie is right. You have been very intolerant of those young men. They must have suffrage inequality. Can't you just look for one?
Well, I'll try. You know, they say that some people can even become immune to a mosquito.
Mom, there is Brother Skinny Bites to sell. It's real cheap, only $200.
Funny. Mini bites are terribly dangerous. People get hurt on them all the time. And you're too young for one. Besides, you have a perfectly good bicycle.
Who wants to ride no bike? Every time I'm in a dinner fight, I'll get hurt or something. You're always dating me. Please, Mom. Please.
I wouldn't be able to sleep nights worrying about you.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. I'll bet you I won't even be able to drive a car either. When I'm an old man, I'll have to walk everywhere. I'll bet you.
Now, buddy, I don't want to discuss this. They are really too dangerous.
Get me that mini bike.
Buddy, run along and we will talk about this.
Go on biking out with your mother alone.
Not until she promises to get that mini bike. Run along, we'll discuss it later.
What's that discussion? You've already told me no.
You always doesn't know to start with. But I'll get it all right. I always do.
Hi, Moose, Dad. I'm really sorry about last night. Christmas.
Oh, forget it.
Good break, Nettie. Don't you dress in the morning?
Why? What's on your mind?
Pete painted that the CMW. Purple.
It's hot. You want to see it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, bad.
Just a minute. I'll be down in a second. I think I better go get dressed.
Where's the cop?
Stop it!
bike. Now go on.
No, it's not a bike.
Oh.
Is this frog?
They are terribly dangerous. I wish he hadn't have done that.
What's he gonna do with it?
Well, your mother passed her way here probably. Park me in the living room so that if you fell out, you wouldn't drown.
Come and say it, Sonny! Son of our cushions and daddy gets his garage to stay after us!
Daddy?
Oh, you gonna go to? You gonna go to?
I don't know, Daddy.
Come and see!
Oh, you go with Buddy. I'll see it later.
Aren't you going out?
No.
What do you want to take the wind out and see if I'm going to have
Well, he doesn't care if I'm particularly interested or not.
What do you mean, doesn't care?
Well, I slept in the guest room last night. He didn't even bother to come in.
You slept in the guest room?
Well, I was just so upset, I just went in and shut the door.
Oh, I'm getting so I have more respect for that boy all the time.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, you should see. Daddy's going with his golden candy all the way. You know, you say that he loves you, but if you keep pulling stunts like that, he'll forget that he ever did.
Mother, he was so rude to Nettie last night.
Oh, she ought to be used to it. Good night. You know what that little kid was getting in here? George, he helped himself to all your soda pop. And that goon brought with him. Turns this thing on so loud it got blacked out. Those hooks his feet up there and then that guy goes... Oh, no, 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 no.
Granddaddy always said, a woman's like a Jersey cow. Keep her contented, she'll give you more cream. You know, maybe I should have brought home that meat coat. She'll enjoy it whole time.
Well, she does it way well. In fact, I think I'll take a board game myself.
Well, make you a bargain. First time you stand up on that, I'll buy you the meat coat.
Hey, that's a deal! I'm going to get up on stage this afternoon!
Haven't
given
the
flowers out there, look at that! I told Winston this morning, will
he? We'll find out, I got flowers. How far is the side back, hey?
Oh, about
You ladies want to wrestle up some lunch while I go get some tea?
Can I go upstairs with that dandy?
Sure. It's clean for us.
you there? Did you see my wallet?
Yes, she got it.
I didn't open it, and they did.
They? Look, if you're a little short on cash, you'd be happy to run to a lunch.
I don't need any money, thank you. I was only...
You could see if I had a girlfriend. I wanted to make sure you were so curious and touch a little hushy, all like that.
I was not curious. I was only
looking for something to read. Well, it looks like you found it.
Look, I don't care about this article or not. I don't care whether you play football. It doesn't make
a
difference.
I do not play football.
I told you I'm not interested.
Casper, Casper, did you tell Mom I
was... Oh, shut up! Danny, that is uncalled. But he makes me so darn mad!
You know, when she gets mad, she swells up like one of our teeny heads. Sounds like one, too.
Well, let's go. Hey, Yeah, the store says the back bag is a little rough.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's pick a little up when we get there.
Where's your suit?
My suit?
Yes, your suit. Or are you that kind of girl?
It's kind of first time. I think she really thinks she should wear
one. Maybe so.
Come on, you two. We don't have all day.
I'm not going, and neither am I.
Going.
Well, Chris, I'm not a mind reader. If you would have come in and waken me up this morning, I could have done the Saturday shopping and the cleaning.
You mean you're going to sit here and clean house all day?
I always clean house on Saturdays. When you work all week, you have to.
You don't work anymore.
Well, I still have to get it done.
Oh, we don't want to get that.
I just couldn't enjoy myself knowing I had to come back to a messy house.
Nettie's
plan.
Did you do it?
Nettie's responsible for her own room.
You the rest of the house?
Well, I like things done a certain way.
All right. Teach Nettie how you want it done, and she can do it. You're a big girl, aren't you?
Yes, I am a big girl. Big enough to make up my own mind. Saturday's my day off. I'm going swimming.
Right after.
Come on, I'll help you. What's this costume with a brush fire?
Debbie, get your mom's suit and bring it out to the car, will you? Come on, you'll love it.
But Chris, I still think...
That's your problem. You think too much.
But Chris!
Oh, give her a little responsibility. And do her good.
What's the matter, Captain Stu?
Clean the whole house.
Miss, how much money you got?
Money? Are you kidding?
Could you get some?
Look, I spent all my allowance on those new pipes I got. If I ask my old man for one more cent, they'd have a heart attack. Wait a second.
Well, that's not enough for what I've got in mind. Just a minute. I'll go get my birthday money.
That's my life about my woman. She's always ever to help with the account. No kidding, Jack. She could do better. What's she got anyway?
Two boyfriends. Last night she dumped me. Well, I can't figure out why.
I bet I don't even know.
Well, always something, huh? Yeah. What'd she say?
She said she was going with Elmer Peters. Kennedy's face had more, character.
Wait a minute, Drax. Where's my money?
Give me part, please.
Dad, could you get my dad to please come to church? Rag? That's my guy. Oh, sure, it's wrong.
What?
I wish I was more like you, but I'm afraid I'm like Mrs. Egbert. Why?
on, come on, Anita.
Mother, Sonny's not upstairs in his room.
I don't know. I can't even
remember
my own.
But he wouldn't be
there.
That's what they
take.
Oh, they did. I'm sure that's where it was. Mother.
Oh, don't get so upset. He's just over at my house. Sheila, go on over.
Oh, I don't think he's over there. There's no light on.
Mother, I've got an awful premonition.
Oh, for goodness sake, Connie. This boy's all right. Why, he took care of himself just fine.
I remember one time when Master comes home, I was 11. Well, that made little Thomas, he scared me to jump off my front porch. That's what I did. And I broke my collarbone, and I don't think he's dead. I mean, it was like 4 hours before my time to go home. And another time.
Oh, God, listen. Don't you think your mother might be worried about you?
Of course not. This is actually the point about Danny. This kid's Thursday before I die. Does he know about she gets married? I'd be considered a bold man, so.
If you could find the bold-fledged idiot who would marry you.
No, this is Fisher. This is Connie. The study has to be over there. Oh, yes. So, you were just down for a little while in the time. Okay, well, thank you. Mother, that boy has run away.
Oh, nonsense. What did he run to? He's just over to my house.
Get a few birds of a song anyway. Hey, Mrs. Sandwich.
Oh.
Well,
thank you, but I certainly will go ham for it. Oh, me too. Don't you still look? What
are we going to do
here?
You'd like that, wouldn't you, Connie?
You're
buying a Sherwood. I'll have to go home and get some money first. Ah, come on. You're the time of something else in the wallet. I sure can't
pick them. Some idea where Nettie was. Maybe she knows where he's gone. But he's not over there. He hasn't even been there. How do you know? Did that keep the pie in the refrigerator? He's still there.
He's run away. I know it.
Oh, don't worry. He'll come back when he gets hungry.
Oh, sure. That's all you care. He could be gone for good and it wouldn't bother you.
But he's not the type of kid to run away.
Well, why isn't he?
He's scared of the dark.
Oh!
Wherever he is, we can bet you $1,000. He's not terrified.
Then well, how do you know he isn't?
Being terrified takes too much energy.
Oh! That's just the typical thing that your fault in the first place. If you hadn't made such a big deal over him cleaning that garage. No, you had to make an example.
Sure, you let everybody else go. Everybody in the whole neighborhood.
But no, not him. But he is a very sensitive child. I don't blame him for running away. I'd run away too if I felt that unloved and uncared for.
Oh, for goodness sake, Connie, that boy had loads of time to get that garage clean before we ever did. You pampered him entirely too much.
Mother, please, just make him down worse. He's run away and he'll be hungry and cold.
That's a safe bet. I've never seen him when he wasn't.
Oh, no, look! This has $50 in it. That stupid, he's run away. I know he'll be hungry and cold.
$50?
Look, if I know Buddy, probably at McDonald's, hamburgers, fresh fries, free chocolate shake.
Do you have to try and be funny at a time like this?
Oh, I guess I'll calm down a little. Guess this. Does anybody call me friend?
How even the pastor boys made by their own
Billy? They moved 6 months ago.
You know, that's right. What? When I was over there with Buddy the other day, we ran into that carnival. What was all people study away from me?
Well, where'd they move to?
Somewhere up on Elm Street next to that ridiculous tea house with all the gingerbread on it.
I'm
going to
get
the car. Oh, we'll get mine. Still got the boat here, too.
I just had some idea where he was. Oh, Mother! Buses! This is open to buses! He's gone to Fresno to build. What's their phone number?
Oh, they wouldn't know anything anyway. He hasn't had time enough to get there.
Well, maybe the bus company does. you tell me if the 12-year-old bought a ticket to Fresno this afternoon? Yes. He did? On the 2:30 bus? Thank you very much. I knew it. I don't know what I could have been thinking. I never should have left him.
Oh, well, listen, don't worry about it. I'll just call Bill and we'll have him meet him over there. And Fred, no.
Well, thank goodness Daddy's got enough sense not to let Fred bother her into this. Oh, no!
What's the matter?
Ride a horse.
Wouldn't that be something? Us riding a horse, isn't it?
Well, your mother would dearly love to have you go home. You've been gone for over 8 hours.
Oh, that's nice. Can you come and
touch the car now? Well, we know. Dee Dee, go home. We might have to use the car.
Mama would just sort of have to go in here and see our TV for morning.
Well, you better go on to bed.
because if I'm obedient, she'll be here at the crack of dawn.
Hey, is your lot from home?
Yeah, it is. Like they got two of them. One dear John and one dear Dad.
Dear Dad?
Yeah. It wasn't addressed to me, but I'm the one she wrote to.
This is the runningest away girl I ever seen. Hey, Uncle Chris, want me to go get her again? Totally wouldn't mind. What do you want that funny looking man? I'd either like to find out if she's like her since she's down.
She's anything like her mother. She's a lot of woman.
Has Connie written?
Yeah.
What'd she say?
Nothing. Stuck me in the rut.
Doggone, sure to get me mad, wasn't it? She doesn't mean this. I'm leaving you business?
I reckon she does.
Looks like you have the shortest marriage of anyone in Tennessee.
Yeah, looks that way.
You like your sister.
Yeah, I've grown a lot.
Well, sure, we're surprised you didn't marry such a wife. Well, I guess you kind of figured you never would again.
I never thought I would either. After playing Betty Littler's Hill, I didn't think I'd ever look at another woman again.
Well, sure, why looking at you? The Eloise Perkins mother you got married to, and I got plastered.
Eloise? She's the best drink in her life.
She had a wand for that time. Well, what do you expect? You've been after you for about 7 years now? How did it happen? I mean, well, what made you run off and get married? You left this home as usual with three men. A week later, we had word to his wife, the wife of his kids.
Believe me, it wasn't premeditated. I'm pretending it's rejection, just like the home. I'm trying everything I can think of to get out of it, but he wouldn't have it. So I rented a monkey suit and I went. Of course, I was about as comfortable with a horse on the street.
Well, when you got there, did you notice Connie right off?
No, I didn't. We were sitting at this table, and I was looking over this top of corn, wondering if it was going to die. When I heard this voice say, "Knock on the door." Well, I looked up to see Connie smiling at me.
What about the cow?
I don't know. Maybe I had the whole thing.
How soon did you find out to get all these kids?
Oh, it was about 2 o'clock in the morning. I wasn't unhappy, though. Of course, that's the kind of thing a guy likes to do for himself, but I figured a good head start wouldn't hurt anything. My problem was, the first night I moved in, I figured I had to have them all stocked and corralled by dark. Well, I got a lot of those best kids.
I don't give you that. The weekend, I was 12, did my scout troop up in the mountains. Those guys are still talking about that vacation.
Boys, maybe. Girls, no. My problem was, I was the leader. I just got a lot to learn about you.
You think Connie was this big-headed when she was 15?
Don't blame Connie. She's like what I figured her mother was like when she was 16.
You think Connie was a big-headed?
Well, could have been. How would you feel if some big old moved into your place?
Don't get me wrong, I like girls fun. But you get two hoosier ones that didn't have any. But this girl is spoiled and wild.
Yeah, I didn't have to go up to be there.
Don't pay attention to this note, it doesn't make any sense.
What do you know?
I just broke one leg.
You mean you were going to elope too?
Nah, I just run away. Got as far as Nashville and takes the ride back home. Boy, was I glad when I found out nobody had read that note.
What do you mean, nobody? Your dad showed it to me, to your grandma.
To the whole Barker clan.
Your mother says, go after him, but your dad says, no, let him go. No boy's worth his salt, so we're going to hog, loot, or die.
You're going to take me along to find out.
For Connie's sake, I hope he doesn't say it. It's any wrong, either.
Yeah, me too.
You liked her, didn't you, John?
Yeah, I liked her. The kind of girl like to run barefoot through the meadows.
Not my goodness.
What was that cow patting?
I know one thing for George thinks about a lot sooner than I.
Well, Chris, what have you decided? Are you going to try to catch her over at the airport or here in prison?
Neither?
Well, you
didn't
buy the letter.
It was a humdinger, all right.
Well, what are you going to do?
Well, come morning, Johnny and I are going to fish.
Hey, look at this, Blair. Only 10 bucks for garage sale. 6 pounds of down and that. They'll keep going. It's like 10,000 feet. You know, this town sure is a lousy place to live in, but you sure can't find some dirt cheap.
How do you like that?
Hey, you're probably going to find the what? 3 months now?
Well, I found one that only a whale could follow, though, so I broke it down in 3 days.
How do you think we can get the key off?
Where are you going?
Good morning, buddy. Quarter after 4. Took the shoes off right over there. You pussy put it up the stairs. You listened to my door while I snored for a while. Then you went on down to the guest room and went to bed.
Well, how did you get your snore?
It's on this bank to hear a coyote stopping a sheep in a hailstorm. It's half a mile away.
I slept with Carlos tonight. Weren't you worried?
Nope. Figured you'd come in when you got tired.
And where's Mom? Where did she go there?
Around Fresno, I guess.
Fresno?
She heard you took the bus up there.
Yeah, I was there. She didn't say she was talking about it, didn't she? So I was there.
I guess you had your fun, huh? That doesn't hurt.
Well, aren't you going to phone her or something?
Nope.
Well, I'm still working.
Well, women are just born very good.
What about me?
I'll be. This isn't a runaway family. Then me and Johnny's gonna run away too.
Well, how long are you going for?
Maybe some shelf life.
Is Betty coming back?
That must have come back here to us, though.
Yeah, it won't run off.
I'm here.
That's right.
What do I do?
I mean, you always do. Don't get me wrong, buddy. There's nothing wrong with being a sitter. Life's pretty easy for them. They just sit and watch TV, sit and think. Where I come from, there's a lot of sitters. Whether it's sidekicks, zombies, and then
Hey, Tom, Pico's. Of course, Bryce got all there. I'm Tom Brooks. He got hit in the head that major.
Well, they surely got a good time just to sit. Well, they sit on the front steps of that post office. Think and sit, sit, think. You know, one of these days they're going to come up with a good idea. Of course, they never have yet, but they sure do have a good time just
to sit.
Well, well, well. Look who's here! Did you come to help?
Help what?
Are you kidding?
Oh, you always leave our cabin, please. So, why don't you go up there and do the dishes? And then, you can come down here and tell you now. That's the story. Disturbs you, your boy, there. You might get sick. You don't want anyone to disturb the same.
Shut up!
And then, maybe you'll get done with a little bit more expensive.
Mary, come on, be decent! Oh, come on!
I am. I'm up to it.
out there.
What do you mean?
It is Hospital 11 is kind of hard to let this off.
Yeah, he's doing the same thing as you did. Pulling off that kind of stuff. Whatever possessed the two of you to pull a stunt like that? What has your mother ever done to deserve it?
Got married, didn't she?
Oh, but she came to talk to both of you before she did. She didn't go running off without telling you and loping and leaving the boat. Well, what happened? Could you talk me into it?
I never intended to talk me into it. I hope I never see it again as long as I live.
Are you home? Had a nice night?
No.
One night you're like that.
Well, what happened?
Well, I asked Moose to take me to the blue spider.
The blue spider? That son? Why, see this thing you two kicked in there? I'm going to report them.
You needn't bother, Grandma. I'm never going back again.
What, did you throw you out?
No, I walked out of there. And I ran home. I ran the night home. And I threw him away, and I put him all in my shoe and I placed him in the cold, and Moose got drowned!
Drowned?
Oh, he just sat there. He found everything I had, and he drank 7 beers all in a row, and he just sat there and cried.
What did he cry about?
Because I didn't have any more money! And the manager told him to go home because he's drunk and he fought everybody. I've never been so embarrassed in my whole life before I ran out and I ran home and here I am.
Okay, why today?
I hope I never see you again as long as I live.
Oh, no, no. Nothing could be that bad.
But I made Mom leave home.
Oh, no, I get credit for that one.
And you've
been all right, don't you? Yeah. Ran a lot of for sure. She'll come home a lot sooner if I'm not here.
I'd like to
what?
I want to go with it.
Probably
watch the
little
kids. I'm
mostly in all the right places, and we're really good at that.
Okay, I'm always trying to talk to you around. That's why I'm
don't carry anyway. My dad from that same bunch must have stepped on our fresh cement.
They didn't, did they?
Oh, no, huh?
They just wrote me same letters. They wrote, Pete Murphy said don't step in this here fresh cement.
You know, I get my license in 2 months, so I'm going to come up for a sports car. Would that be hot?
I as well have a loose for 16.
All the parents had a fit. Even my mom.
The way I look at it,
he's got money. Why not spend it?
Oh, it's moose and drag. I swear that moose lives here.
Look, look, he's at the top of the car. Look.
What will you do with rain?
Who cares? It's awesome.
Yeah, well, the driver we gave her push. What do you think?
She's got personality like nothing on the road.
Hold on, how about a drink first? That thing weighs a ton, we're wasted.
You know, I'm going to install a pest machine in the slot. I'll make enough money off of you guys and send me to college.
She's worried about college? Like that she never even makes it through high school.
Oh, that's you keep saying around here and how you did last year. Well, you've lived here.
Oh, look, that's the way my woman wanted it.
Well, hon, she's got a new dad, and she'll have different ideas.
What? My woman's got a 16. Great, please. Take the suitcases out there last night, and I couldn't find a place to sit them down.
Look, if you're trying to prove you're the world's best dad, I've got news for you. You're not! What's more, I'll get that money, and I will get it cleaning up some dirty old garage.
All right. Why don't you say we go in the kitchen and get some?
No, I want to stop the cover soon, and you're all gone. Go to the kitchen.
Well, later. I'll fix you up some eggs.
No, I hate it. I want to stop the cover soon.
Flapjacks. Well, I'll make you some flapjacks to make them donuts taste like sawdust.
I don't like them. I never taste them. I'd rather have
them. Well, come help me stir them up.
I don't want to.
I can't do that. I gotta get breakfast for your mom.
Why?
Well, because she's the one I married, so I've got to be real nice.
Aren't you nice to me?
Sure I am.
Then go to the store and get some chocolate covered donuts.
Later, I've gotta get breakfast for your mom.
Why?
Oh, because she's the one I gotta be real nice to now. You come help this old guy go get some breakfast.
You're a nice
dog.
You're
not
an old
meanie. Well, how about helping this old meanie go get some breakfast?
No.
I can't get you that donut. I'm sorry.
No, but you
don't. No, you don't. Now you asking for it, gal. Oh, good morning. I'll be through here in a minute. There.
Well,
if
he's saying you won't get anything,
he's not
even a
wild mouthful. Oh, yes, I will. Blackstone, you so full of eggs and flapjacks, you'll just burst.
Well, he thought you were wonderful, right? I managed to do that in that shop since the day she was born.
Well, you did once, remember?
Oh, yes, and Connie never let me forget.
Thank heaven she's not down yet.
Oh, don't.
What's the price, Mommy? got me something, Jonas. I won't color it.
Come on.
Yes, dear.
We've got chocolate covered donuts. Maybe a freaking art.
I want chocolate covered donuts.
I'm so glad that you and Debbie are getting to know each other, Chris.
Yeah.
Children have needed a father so terribly. Children in their little faces. There's a definite need for something. Don't you notice?
Yes, I have.
I know you're going to be so understanding with us, but I want you to be firm, too. Oh, not that they're spoiled, but they are independent. I taught them to stand on their own feet, make their own decisions. Oh, you would want to see them their way, I'm sure. Why, Nedra buys her own clothes and plans her own parties. She's very mature. And Buddy, why, he's never in any trouble at all. Why, he's been so self-occupied lately. I hardly even noticed he's been around.
Except when he wants money.
Money?
Yeah, he wanted to wake you up a little while ago. Said he had to have a machine done.
Oh, obviously, I've told that boy time and time again. Your mind. Number one, you are not
my father. And number two, what I do is none of your business.
Never. That was
very
rude.
And you two were very rude. You had no right to embarrass my friend. Which is real funny about things like that. He just may never go back.
I never knew that boy was so sensitive.
Look, all I ask is if you quit treating me like a child. So that you know whether or not I'm perfectly able to take care of myself. So lay off! Doing a
anything good to us. He's mean and stingy and everything.
Me? Yeah. He's got things all the way to clear the yard.
Well, I didn't dig out the trash for you. So there.
Well, you can do it now, son.
He can't make me take
off. Oh, yes, I can. Now, I told you to take out that trash this afternoon. Now, why didn't you do it then?
I'm not going to be your slave.
Christopher always takes care of that.
Not anymore.
None of the other kids have to pick up trash.
Things are different here in the city than they are in the country.
City or country, 12-year-old boy's got to do some work.
Oh, but he has the rest of his life to work. I want him to remember his childhood and his carefree happy time.
They're carefree, all right. Look, you got it all wrong. Laziness simply didn't make a happy kid. Now you get out there and take out that trash.
But it's dark!
And then turn the light on. There's nothing going to get you. You're too plain skinny. Now get done.
Oh, and I did so want you to fight.
Well, whether that boy likes me or not, beside the point, he's got to learn to do some work. You know, I think first thing tomorrow, I'm going to go down to the paper office and see about getting him a paper route.
Oh, no, that would cause nothing but trouble. And there isn't another child in this whole neighborhood who has a paper route.
Well, it's high time there was.
Yes, really.
If you still put her papers, we'll get him a morning route.
Oh, no. That would mean getting up at 5 a.m.
Yeah, I got up at 5 a.m. when I was his age to milk cows, and it won't hurt
him. Trim, these children are happy, well-adjusted human beings.
Trying to do, but I don't like it.
Oh, I'm just trying to make things easier on you, hon.
Easier?
No, when you tell a kid to do something, you ought to see that he does.
Oh, why cause all that trouble? Just don't tell them to do anything.
You get it, I'm just too upset.
Well, the love of Pete John!
How are you doing?
What are you doing here?
I came with a load of corn. What's the girl doing coming down the tree out there?
Nettie, will you get in here? You go after her for me.
Be right glad to.
Can you believe that little weasel squirming out of that upstairs window like that? Well, does she sneak out like that all the time?
There's never been any need for her to do that before.
Let me know! Mother, who is he?
Oh, you twink and her deuce.
No!
Yeah, he... Johnny, this here's Nettie. This here's Johnny Cross, the nephew of mine.
You know, Chrissy ain't that.
How?
Of course, you kicked her in that girl man. But you know, once you're broke, don't make a pretty nice house pet. Carolyn's the one after, isn't she?
Alone?
Alone? He's stuck out there.
Would you please quit treating me like a child? That's none of your business.
Someone's likely to come on one of those dark corners. You don't see how I'm your hair yet.
Mother, would you please ask him to move?
You know, we had a cold because I'm working out of a pasture once. Remember, Mother? We finally had a hobble.
Your hick-town humor is making me sick. Now, if you'll please excuse me.
Here's your other running away shoes. I'm going to trash you. You must have myself climbing on trees. You only need two pairs. One for climbing on trees, one for running. You know, just be fast even then if I know it's going to mean you ought to drop my lasso. Never run across that lawn. Did you play for church or something?
Yo, Danny, get out here.
Well, I declare that doesn't sound like a nice call sniper bird. What about that those things right here in those big cities? Uncle Chris. You think they ought to go gunning for it?
You might as well. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if there wasn't a pair of them out there. Hey, folks!
Mother! You've got me on the right to do this!
Why don't you come on in? You're by dirty. Isn't quite tomorrow yet. But then it soon will be. Sit down. Boys, do you have something out there? no one's out there looking around for something. Right. We better go.
Well, my nicey boys drop by, and if we find out what you've been looking for, we'll be sure and lock it up and keep it safe for you.
Frank. Come on, Greg. The mighty friendly fellows. Sure don't lock much, though. They sure like to come visiting. That's the third time they've been here today.
And here all the time I thought city folks were neighborly.
Well, why didn't you tell me I wanted to dance? Well, I'm a part of these big girls. Just be shy.
I'm going to bed.
You forgot your other running away, Sue.
You all look pretty silly running away with this one to you on. Oh, well, here's that one light and broom.
He's determined to do it. He has to be the bull with.
Not because you need changing, no. This is proof that Mr. Christopher Barker is a big shot. A he-man from the wild in spaces.
Oh, that was quite a preach.
Oh, he's not changing me. I will not give in to him one single inch.
Forget it. Doesn't matter.
Good grief, man. Don't you ever get dressed?
What
have
you got in mind?
Well, Sean Simmons is painting his old man's car purple.
Hi,
you want to see it?
Yeah!
Great, let's get dressed and go.
I'll be down in a minute. I'm going to go get dressed here.
Came in here, helped himself to some soda pop, help yourself to candy. And that goomy brought with him. What is that thing on it?
Betty Dazzler!
Oh, and I'm saying that if you want him, you would have gone out that bed, come down and fixed him that breakfast.
Oh, no, Mother. He's got to be the one to make the first move. So please go on, too.
Connie, you grumpy dog. You picked yourself blind man.
Oh, please, Miss Douglas, you're turning in the middle of the street. And could just wait to him like a little long-lost friend. And then he invited him to go fishing. And the cops didn't even give us a ticket.
Oh, he's as friendly as a St. Bernard puppy.
He invited Danny Solis to both go fishing. Oh, and Mother, he says he might be glad to go for at least a week. Sounds like loads of fun. He says there's places we can act up to where even I can catch the fish. Oh, by the way, did he mind? Oh, it's my smoky sister. Oh, I'm so excited. I've always wanted to buy her tea. He says this one lady is so clear.
everybody else can be coming right along. But if you want to ride in, I guess we'll have to.
He's bad.
I found a guy who plays it just awfully slow. Do they play football in Tennessee?
Now, let's delve in there. School is the most up to the big trophy. Come on, sir.
How many did you get?
Edie! She'll believe anything.
Oh, I do not. Well, we better get off this.
And a pair of goggles.
What are goggles?
She's a duck out of glass. Sure gets real dusty when you want to ski. Real dusty. I'll be back here by 12:30.
Okay! I haven't got any goggles!
Davey, honestly!
But he sounded like he meant it. Look, there's a
lot of... Oh, I see him! Let me see!
Is it him?
Look! It's him!
I thought he said they didn't play football in Tennessee.
Johnny Bronson, touchdown, in the final quarter, Cinch's title for Huskers!
Johnny Bronson, Randy quarterback of Division today, beat the Tennessee
and he never mentioned it.
I mean, just never talked about anything else.
No kidding. I get so tired of hearing him brag. Oh, my God.
Here
comes
me! Did you have
10 minutes, Bruce?
Okay, but hurry up.
Oh, hi, what are you doing here?
Let me ask you just one question.
Okay.
Johnny, you said you couldn't stand.
That's right.
But he's gorgeous!
He's nothing but a Tennessee geek who makes me sick.
Good!
What do you mean, good?
Oh, nothing.
I like it, sister. I'll see you sleepy last time.
Oh, you're just going someplace?
Yeah, swimming. Why?
Good!
What do you mean?
He would! Oh, nothing. I just thought it was so great that she could go swimming!
Something's cooking me, too. What is it?
Everyone's one.
So what?
Will you play
close? Oh, gimme now. Come on, he is just pressing me up deeply and he's been talking about it. So excuse me, I've got a few questions on.
I don't think you'll press too much either because you've got something.
What are you doing?
Hey, well, hey, where's your suit?
My suit?
Hey, you gotta have a suit.
Unless you're one of that kind of girls.
Well, it's Connie's first time, maybe she should wear one.
Yeah, maybe so. Well, come on, you two. We haven't got all day.
Not going. Neither am I.
Well, what do you mean you're not going?
Well, Chris, I'm not a mind reader. If you would come in and
anymore.
But it's still Saturday.
All right, we'll clean when we get back.
I could have constantly enjoying myself knowing I have to come home to her and look at the house.
Okay, then. Maddie will clean it.
Maddie is responsible for her own room.
And you for the rest of the house.
I've always done it. I like things done a certain way.
Well, tell her how you like them done and she'll do them. You're a big girl now. Well, aren't you?
Yeah. Big enough to make up my own mind. Saturday is my day up. And I'm going swimming.
After you clean the house.
Come on. I'll help you. We're going to the top of the brush fire.
Debbie, you run up and get your mom's suit, and you bring it right on out to the car. Now, come on. You don't love it.
But I still don't think that...
That's your problem. You think too much.
I still don't.
Oh, give her some responsibility. Be good for her.
What is it? What's the matter,
last night, you don't. What I can't figure out is why.
Yeah. What exactly did she say? She said she was going with Elmer Peters. Kind of his spacehead was a character. You know, have you seen my girl anywhere? I can't remember where it was. Oh, thanks.
No.
What do you think, Clara, was never to give pipes, huh? Oh. Well, I spent all the money I had on them. I think I can live a little bit to respect out of my friends.
All right.
If
find a full-fledged idiot, Lord, where are you?
Come on, little sister. Haven't you put your
Oh, my baby's alone! He loves me!
Move!
She says she won't have to work.
Oh, why did I ever do it? Chris has ruined my baby's life.
Chris? I thought it was loose.
Oh, well, she would have never done it if Chris hadn't asked her to clean his house.
Oh, God.
Oh, that was good, all right. I put it all over that.
I'm going to call Mrs. Father. We should be talking to Hello, Mr. Mallaby. This is Sandra Edwards' mother. Did you know that your son has eloped with my daughter?
What did he say?
Good. Now I don't have to pay that damn car. Do you have to be so talented?
For goodness sake, Tommy, they have them. They both, in the first place, they're both on your age. And it would take both parents' consent to be able to marry. And if I know Booth, as soon as he gets hungry, he's going to head right here for your refrigerator. My poor since he's been going with Ned, but he hasn't eaten as much as water at home.
When she won't come home, you know, Nettie, once she makes up her mind, she'll go through with it, even if she has to starve to death. Oh, why could Chris have a little bit understanding of this? Such a dictator. Oh, I've made some mistakes in my life, and this is the biggest. Mother, I'm don't be silly. You know you love me. Well, that doesn't matter. Well, what are you going to do?
I'm going to get on a plane.
Hello? Did you think I would have a 12:15 to make home right away? Thank you. Now, there's a plane that leaves at 11:15. If I just hurry, I could make it. Okay, I'll make it. The Bill's house around the same time as the bus gets there. Give Arnie to Chris, and I'll call you the minute that I get there.
some money and you can do Sunday tomorrow.
Yeah, but I wanted to stay the night with you anyway.
Where are you going?
I'm going to look for
Betty.
I
want to
go too.
Sweetheart, it's too late. Well, goodbye, Denise. We'll see you. Remember, I'll phone you the minute I get there.
Well, you mean to try to get a hold of Bill and have him meet that person for 26.
She sure worried. That's because we're playing language. We couldn't find Betty. So, we want to get tired.
But you know, for your age, you're a lot smarter than your mother.
She hasn't talked to me once.
Nope, just ice cream.
Then I won't go. I don't like cream. I just like chocolate and maybe.
Who's the blood in the taxi? Oh, Connie. Well, where's she going? Well, she's flying down to Fresno. She just found out that Buddy was there. Well, why? Why didn't you let me drive her up there?
Did Buddy come?
No. Connie called the bus station. They said that a 12-year-old boy had bought a ticket. Fresno. Well, there's a lot of 12-year-old boys. You might be going up there on a wild goose chase. Well, the grocery money was gone, and the phone book is open to buses in the old section. Well, what airport's that wife of mine Stacy is going to? I'm going to go have to bring her back. Oh, international, I believe. Oh, but Chris, before you go, you better leave this.
From Connie?
Oh, there's another one. This one's from Heather.
Oh, I haven't got this much mail since my birthday.
Well, Sheila, let's go put Daddy to bed over at my house.
I don't want to go to bed. I want to stay with Daddy. I want to stay with Daddy.
Come on, and no yelling.
Daddy,
ow! He bit me.
Well, at least you've won one of them over, and me.
Well, in most marriages, that's the biggest battle.
Well, I don't know what she put in that letter. But, Chris, I know one thing. This family needs you in the very worst way.
Well, that's the way they got me. Well, finally got her home. Of course, I just went out 3 times so she's going inside. Now, if her mom will only put her to bed, you won't hear anything on the TV till morning.
Well, you better get set, because if I don't need it, she'll be here at the crack of dawn.
Hey, you get a letter from home? Yeah, this home. Two of them back. One dear John and one dear Daddy.
Dear Daddy?
Yeah, it's not addressed to me, but I'm the one she wrote it to.
This is the runningest away girl I ever seen. Uncle Chris, you want me to go get her again?
Nah.
Really wouldn't mind. I think about that fighting little command. I feel like if I know it's like to sit down.
Well, if she's anything like her mother, she's a lot of woman.
What'd she say?
Nothing. She just wrote me a letter, too.
Oh, no, I'm sure they didn't mean mail, isn't it? She doesn't mean us to some living business.
No, I reckon she does.
Looks like you have the shortest marriage of anyone.
It doesn't look that way.
You like her?
Yeah, I like her. I like her a lot.
Oh, sure, we're surprised being married looks like. I guess the kind of business you never really get.
Well, neither did I. You know, after Faye and Betty Lou were killed, you know, I just didn't want to even think about any other woman.
Well, there were plenty who were thinking about you. When Eloise Perkins found out you got married, she went out and got plastered.
Eloise! Well, she never took a drink in her life.
She took a lot for this time. What do you expect? She's been chasing after you for what, 7 years now? How? How does it happen? What made you go out and get married? You left as usual, free man, and then a week later, you got word you had a wife and 3 kids.
Well, believe me, it wasn't premeditated. You know, I was one of them receptions that Cliff Owens was given. I didn't want to go, and I did everything I could to get out of it, but you know Cliff, he talked me into it. So I rented one of them pumpkin suits. As usual, I felt about as comfortable as a horse on a freeway.
So when you got there, you noticed Connie right off?
No. I was sitting at the table, looking over a piece of cob on the corn, or corn on the cob. I was trying to decide if it was one of ours or not. Suddenly I heard this voice that said, well, one of yours. When I turned around, there was Connie smiling at me. well, what about the cop?
Hey, I don't know. Maybe I even hate that thing.
How soon did you find out she had all these kids?
Well, it was about 2 o'clock that morning. But I was real happy about it. I've always wanted a big family. Of course, that's something a fellow kind of likes to do on his own. You know, there's nothing wrong with having a good start. But my trouble was, though, the first day I was here, I acted like it was roundup time. I had to have everyone in the corral before dark. Guess I got a lot to learn about kids.
Don't give me that. When I was 12, these my scouts come up to the mountains. Those guys are still talking about that trip.
Well, boys maybe, but girls, no. Yeah, I was too eager. The funny thing was, I just never knew what Connie was like at 16.
Remember Connie was this big-headed?
Now, don't blame Eddie. I mean, what would you do if some big loop came into your house and started ordering you around?
Well, don't get me wrong, I like girls as fuck. I wouldn't get too hoosed when they didn't have any. But this girl was spoiled for mine.
Well, maybe so, but I still need to go off the deep end.
Don't pay attention to what the note says. It doesn't mean anything.
How do you know?
Well, I kind of wrote one out.
Oh, yeah? Now, you were figuring out he'd help me, too?
Nah, I'm just getting married. I just... running away. Got as far as Nashville and it's right back home. Boy, was I glad when I found no one had read that note.
What do you mean? Nobody. Your pa, so to be, and your grandma, and the whole Parker class. You know, your mom wanted your father to laugh at you, but he said, nope, let him go. No kid worth his salt until he finds out what it's like to root hog or die.
Sure didn't take me long to find out, did it?
Well, for Connie's sake, I hope it doesn't take Nettie long either.
Yeah, me too.
Like her, do you, Connie?
Yeah, I like her. She's the kind of girl I'd like to run barefoot to the tulip.
Not my tulip.
Well, without the top hat,
well, one thing for sure, she'll come back a lot sooner if I'm not here.
Well, Chris, what have you decided? Are you going to try to catch her over at the airport or meet her in prison?
Neither.
Neither? Well, that would be fine weather.
It was a humdinger.
Well, what are you going to do?
Well, I tell you what. First thing in the morning, me and Johnny here is going fishing.
Hey, look at this, will ya? $6 for the garage sale. $6 down in that. That'll keep you over 10,000 feet. You know, this town sure is a lonely place to live in, but you can buy stuff for dirt cheap.
Hey, what do you think of that?
Yeah, you found it. You can look at that large truck. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I had one that only a whale could swallow, so I cut up and made 3 of them.
How big did you go?
Where are you going?
Oh,
morning, Junior.
Did you know I was home?
Yep.
And then, what time did I come in?
About 4:15. You walked in, took your shoes off about there, put me putting up the stairs, stopped my door, listened to me snore for a while, and went to the guest bedroom, went to sleep.
Well, how did you hear me through snoring?
John, this man could hear a coyote duck and a sheep in a hailstorm. Half a mile away.
Well, I slept in the car most of the night. Weren't you worried?
Oh, I figured you'd come home when you got tired.
Where's Mom?
Not looking for you.
Where's she looking?
Fresno, I guess.
Fresno?
Yeah, she thought you'd taken the bus up there.
Yeah, I was kidding. With some people at the station were talking about Disneyland. So I went there.
Well, you had your fun. Now she's out having hers.
Well, aren't you going to try to phone her or something?
Nah.
But she worried.
Well, women are just natural-born worriers.
I think that's awful the way you're treating her. Why, she's probably falling her eyes out right now.
Oh, she's probably up there having herself a good time.
Where's Minnie?
Her
out, too.
Well, I'll be gone, darn. This isn't a runaway family. But then me and Johnny are running away, too.
Well, how long are they going for?
Maybe they'll smoke like
it. Is that you coming back?
What for? Nothing to come back here for. Everybody's run away.
I'm here.
That's right.
What do I do?
Well, you do what you always do. You're sick. Now, don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong with being a sitter. Life's pretty easy for them to sit and watch television or sit and think.
Why, there's a bunch of sinners where I come from. Let's see, the Psyheads, Tom Beanie, and Pete Dawson.
Where Psy's not all there. I'm kind of drunk.
Pete got hit in the head with a hay derrick. They have a real nice time. Well, they just sit on them post office steps and they spit, think, spit. But now, one of these days they might come up with a pretty good idea. Of course, you never have yet. But they sure have a good time just to sit.
Well.
Look who's here!
Imagine that. Coming to help?
Help what?
Well, here's the cuddle.
Are you kidding?
We always leave our cabin clean. So I want you to go up there in position. And then you can come down straight up in here. You sure enough to serve Junior Boy there because he likes to sit. So you don't want nothing to serve his fingers.
Shut up!
And then maybe when you're done, we'll go get your candle with you again.
I just went off my duty. Don't know why everyone's making such a big deal out of it. Everyone has the right to go up once in a while.
When did you get back?
Well, just after you called, say Connie had called.
Well, did she call?
Not here.
Well, I tried calling Jill again, but there still wasn't any answer.
Oh, what for? It's been a long time since she's had a vacation away from you, kids.
You guys have treated her horrible. She's probably all alone out by now.
Or what?
Me and Nettie.
Now, she's probably up there having herself a real good time.
You mean you're not going to do anything?
Of course I am. I'm going to pack up the car and head for the hill.
You don't look like my mom isn't important at all.
Well, of course she's important. But why the big fuss? Everybody ought to have the right to go off once in a while.
Oh, where are they going? Is it sleeping bad? Johnny, I need to come them in right away.
That's right.
And he promised us a hamburger.
Well, where did you come from?
Not your garage.
My garage? For goodness sake, why?
Well, I slept there last night.
Well, did you sleep well?
No, I did not. I nearly froze on that old couch of yours. And whether you know it or not, there is a rat out there.
Well, last night, I had two rats out there.
Where have you been?
Oh, doing the same thing that you have. Both of you been trying to upset your mother. Whatever possessed the two of you to pull a stunt like that? What has your mother ever done to deserve it?
She got married, didn't she?
Oh, yes. But she talked to both of you before she did. She didn't just run off and leave a note. Well, what happened? Couldn't you talk him into it?
Well, I never intended to talk him into it.
Oh, you back? Have a good time?
No.
Well, sometimes you like that.
Well, what happened?
Well, I asked him to speak me to the blue spider.
The blue spider? That guy? If they let you two kids in there, I'm going to report them.
You don't need to bother, Grandma. I'm never going there again. Ever.
What's the matter? They broke you out.
No. I walked out. And I walked all the way home. And I got blisters and a cold and... Moose got drunk.
Drunk?
He borrowed every penny I had and then he drank seven beers all in a row and just... And then he just sat there and cried. I've never been so embarrassed in all my life.
What did he cry about?
Because I didn't have any more money. So they told him to just go home and sleep it off, and then he'd fight everybody. And he called me a cheapskate. He feels bitter on me. So I just ran home and I looked at him. I hope I never live to get a money like this.
Oh, it can't be that bad. Not
Huffington.
But I need Bobby home.
No, I get the credit for that.
Is
this
all right, don't you?
Yeah, she's all right. She'll come back a lot sooner if I'm not here, so I'd better get going.
Well,
sure I will. That is, if you...
Right, that's a lot.
rod. Mom, where's my other pair of sneakers?
Over my house where you left them.
Oh, hurry up, guys. Let's go.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh. You did read the letter to this.
So are you leaving you, Sheila? With Betsy Guard?
Don't try to find me because it won't do any good, Connie.
But what do you mean you're leaving him to me?
Well, he says that you were the kind of girl that a man wants to marry.
Well, making sense. He sure is. That's why we're taking her along. You know, I have a couple bachelors on my farm, and if I could get them married and settle down, they'd do a whole lot more work.
Well, I could have worried about me just a little bit.
Oh, hon, if it'll make you feel better, I'll take you up to the room and I'll show you the rug around that bed where I wore a trench in the foot deep worry. Now, you have 10 minutes to get your gear packed up and out of that car, or we're taking off without you. And you get to find out what it's like to stay up all night worried.